over 150 acres of lush green campus, over 1,200 students, well-qualified and experienced teachers, over 30 industrial tie-ups, placements in national and multinational companies, excellent grade by MSBTE for academic excellence, bagged Best Lab Award by MSBTE, availability of hostel, transport and mess facility. Government and merit scholarships are available. Sanjay Ghodavath Polytechnic, transforming lives for a better world.
Hello everyone, I am Professor N. S. Jadhav from Sanjay Ghodavath Polytechnic. Today, I would like to deliver a lecture on gas insulated substation. Generally, we know the gas insulated substation is nothing but GIS. For that, these are the outlines. In this topic, we discuss following points. First one, substation, conventional substation like AIS. After that, the limitations of air insulated substation. Next one, why the need of gas insulated substation. After that, introduction to the GIS. Next, what is the properties of sulfur hexafluoride gas. After that, GIS assembly. In this, we can include the essential parts of GIS. After that, the advantages of GIS. Next one, what are the limitations in GIS? After that, applications of gas insulated substation. Next one is a single line diagram, SLD. After that, what is the difference between air insulated substation and gas insulated substation? Shall we start now? First one, the substation. An assembly of apparatus installed to control transmission and distribution of electrical power is nothing but substation. This is the schematic diagram of the air insulated substation. In this air insulated substation, there are different components are included in this. First, at the left hand side, this is the incoming end, and right hand side is the outgoing end. First, at the incoming end, number one says the primary power line. Second one, the ground wire. Third one, overhead lines. Number four, transformer for measurement of electrical voltage, nothing but PT. Fifth number is a disconnector switch, nothing but isolator. Next, circuit breaker. It is a protective device, which is a very important device. Also, after that, the circuit breaker. Next one is a CT. CT known as current transformer. It is also measurement and protection purpose. After that, LA. LA in the sense lightning arrester. It is a protection against lightning strokes. After that, the main transformer. This is the power transformer. It is the heart of our power system or heart of our substation. Next one is the control building. All the control panels should be there. After that, security fences is there for the strictly prohibited of unauthorized person, animals or etc. And last one is the secondary power lines. These are the incoming end to the outgoing end of the substation. Next, we discuss the air insulated substation. The air is used as a dielectrical media, also normally used for outdoor substation. These are mostly used as outdoor substation. In a very few cases, usually in indoor substation, the few cases nothing but the area should be more populated. Also, seismic aspect should be there. That is a flood affected area. also the earthquake area, that particular point, this is as an indoor substation. Also, it is easy to expand for a future expansion purpose. The air insulated substation is easily expanded. Also, excellent overview should be there. Simple to handling, it should be handled simply, also easily accessible. This is included all the parts in air insulated substation. Next, the limitations of air insulated substation. The limitations are, it's having larger dimension due to the stationary clearances and poor dielectrical strength of air. Next, the wastage of space because of large area should be there. Also, life of steel structures is degrades because of due to some chemical reactions, and this is placed in the outdoor. That's why. Also, seismic instability. The seismic instability nothing but the environmental aspects, flood, storm, also earthquake should be there. Next one, large planning and execution time. Because of area should be large, therefore component should be large. Also, that's why the planning and execution, also the erection time is very high. Also, day by day maintenance should be required. Next one, the need of GIS. There's all the limitations should be overcome in this GIS. That's why we required the gas insulated substation. When at non-availability of sufficient place, that point we can install the GIS. Also, difficult climatic and seismic condition at site, that particular site we can install the GIS. Also, urban site, when the big city should be there and big building should be there, that's why the AIS is not applicable. That particular point, GIS is applicable. High altitudes, that particular site, also we can prefer GIS. And all the limitations of AIS should be overcome. That's why we need the GIS. After that, we discuss on exact what is the GIS system, what is the gas insulated substation system. Introduction. In this introduction, the GIS is in a compact size. We already says that the AIS area is equal to the 1/10 of GIS. Also, multi-component assembly. All the components are assembled in a compact vessel. Also, enclosed in ground metallic housing. SF6 gas is a primary insulating medium. Also, sulfur hexafluoride gas is a superior dielectrical properties used at moderate pressure for face-to-face and face-to-ground insulation. Because of the moderate pressure, they have not a severe leakage, gas leakage problem should be there. The GIS preferred for the voltage ratings of 72.5 kV, 145 kV, 300 kV and 420 kV. Various components are included in GIS like bus bars, circuit breakers, disconnectors, nothing but isolators, current transformers, potential transformers, load break switches, earthing switches, etc. housed in a metallic enclosed module filled with sulfur hexafluoride gas. Next one, this is the exact site of GIS substation. We see that in this, the compact vessel should be there. In this compact vessel, all the components are assembled. Also, control panel should be there. This is the exact GIS running periphery. Next one, the properties of GIS. Why the GIS is preferable? Because first one is it's a non-toxic. Nothing but it is not harmful to the human life. Next, a very stable chemically up to 500 degrees Celsius. Nothing but this gas is not a chemical reaction up to 500 degrees Celsius. Also, this is a man-made gas. Its lifetime is very long. Is 800 to 3200 years. It's a very long. Next, insulating property is 3 times that of air. Also, it's are chemically inert. That is the it is an inert gas. It's a non-inflammable. No any fire hazard should be there. And last one, the density of sulfur hexafluoride gas is 5 times heavier than air. These are the properties of sulfur hexafluoride gas. Next one, the GIS assembly. In this GIS assembly, the essential parts of gas insulator substation should be there. First one, bus bar, circuit breaker, disconnector in between line or bus, that is the nothing but isolator, earthing switches, also line on bus, CT, feeder or bus, PT, also feeder or bus, feeder disconnector, feeder earthing switch and control panel. This is the schematic diagram of gas insulated substation. In this gas insulated substation, the first one is the circuit breaker interrupter unit. This is the circuit breaker interrupter unit. Next one, store energy spring mechanism. This is the store energy spring mechanism. Third one, circuit breaker control unit. This is the circuit breaker control unit. Next one, bus bar number one. This is the bus bar number one. Next, bus bar disconnector for first. Next one, bus bar second. Next, bus bar disconnector number 2. Number 8, work in progress earthing switch. This is number 8. Also, work in progress earth switch for bus 2. Next, outgoing feeder disconnector. This is number 10. This is outgoing feeder terminal. Make proof earthing is number 11. This is either. After that, the current transformer is there. Voltage transformer. This is the voltage transformer. And cable and line should be there. Is the number 14. This is also another schematic diagram. Already we can see. After that, the bus bar. We generally know what is the bus bar. It is an electrical conductor that carries a large current, especially one that is a part of power distribution system, typically a thick strip or a tube of copper or aluminium. The exact construction diagram of bus bar should be there. The bus bar is one of the most elementary components of gas insulated system. It's a coaxial bus bar are common in isolated phase GIS, as this configuration results in an optimal stress distribution. Also, bus bar of different lengths are used in GIS to cater to the requirement of circuit or the bay formation. These are the bus bar. This is the bus bar schematic diagram in GIS system. Also, the disconnector. We know generally isolator in AIS and disconnector in GIS. The disconnector or disconnect switches are placed in series with a circuit breaker to provide additional protection and physical isolation. The disconnector is also used as a protection purpose, also the isolation purpose. It is connected in series with a circuit breaker. In a circuit, two disconnectors are generally used, one on the line side and other on the feeder side. The disconnect switches or disconnector are designed for the interruption of small currents induced or capacitive coupled during the closing operation. This gap is bridged by the moving contacts. These are all the points included in the disconnector switch. Next one is a circuit breaker. The figure shows of gas insulated substation circuit breaker. Generally, we know the circuit breaker is, it is a make and break circuit during normal and abnormal condition. It is a protective device. Also, the circuit breaker is the most critical part of gas insulated substation system. The circuit breaker in a gas insulated system is metal clad or utilizes SF6 gas both for insulation and fault interruption purpose. The SF6 gas pressure in a circuit breaker is around 0.65 megapascal. This is the moderate pressure. The circuit breaker is directly connected to either current transformer or the isolator in a gas. A barrier is maintained between the circuit breaker and the other connected equipment operating at lower gas pressure to maintain a pressure difference. Spring, also spring hydraulic and pure hydraulic, are the preferred device for the circuit breaker of a gas insulated substation. Next one is a current transformer, CT. The conventional substation use either live tank or a dead tank type current transformers with oil or SF6 insulation. The porcelain insulator is used to insulate the low potential section of the current transformer from the high voltage zone. Like ribbon or cut steel structure cores are used for the magnetic circuit of the current transformer for obtaining the desired ratio and accuracy. The inductive ring type, and either inside or outside the enclosure, the GIS conductor is a single tier primary of CT, and CT outside enclosures always provide with including joints. Next one, the VT, nothing but the voltage transformer. The schematic diagram should be shown there. It's inductive type with iron core. Primary winding is supported on the insulating plastic film immersed in sulfur hexafluoride gas. A sealed unit from which VT can be easily removable so as GIS can be tested with damaging VT. After that, we explain a earth switch. The fast earth switch and maintenance earth switch are the two types of earth switches used for gas insulated substation system. The maintenance earth switch is a slow device used to ground the high voltage conductors during the maintenance schedules in order to ensure the safety of the maintenance staff. In such a situation, the use of fast earth switch provides a parallel like low resistance path to drain the residual static charge quickly, thereby protecting the instrument voltage transformer from the damages that may otherwise be caused. Snow plating earthing switch are used for protection purpose. The fast closing earthing switch can be closed against full voltage and short circuit power. The high speed earthing switch is achieved by means of a spring closing device. Next one is the control panel. The figure shows the control panel of gas insulated substation. In this, the control panel, all the alarms, all the switches, all any types of reading mode or monitoring, all the devices or data should be there. This is for the control panel. Next one, this is the SLD of gas insulated substation. Like bus 1 and bus 2. The single line diagram of GIS should be there. That is bus 1, bus 2. Disconnector for bus 1, disconnector switch for bus 2. Also earthing switch should be there. Next one is the current transformer, circuit breaker, current transformer number 2, disconnector switch, also earth switch and terminal should be there. Next one, this is the 245 kV GIS general single line diagram should be there. This is the same. Next one, the advantages of GIS. The why the GIS is advantageable? It occupies very less space, 1/10 to the ordinary substation. Hence, most preferred where the area of substation is small, like cities. Most reliable as compared to the air insulated substation. The system is very reliable. The number of outages due to the fault is less because of they having very less maintenance, so outages should be less. It's maintenance free operation. It can be assembled at workshop and module can be commissioned in the plant easily. Next, the protection from pollution. Because of air insulated substation is outside there, therefore there are different types of pollution should be there. That is that's having the harmful effects on that. But the GIS is a compact vessel, therefore its protection against from the pollution. It reduces the switching over voltages, reduces the installation time. Because of compact size, so installation time should be less. Superior arc instruction, because of SF6 is very high grade arc quenching media and properties. And gas pressure is low, that is the moderate pressure. Due to the moderate pressure, the high leakage, gas leakage problem should be eliminated. Also increase the safety also for personnel. Next one, the limitations of GIS. First, high cost, because of this system is very critical and we can utilize the SF6 gas, that's why the cost is very high. Excessive damage in case of internal fault. When the internal fault should be occur, then excessive damage should be there. Requirement of cleanliness are very stringent because of due to the dust deposition and moisture deposition, it is very harmful. Diagnosis of internal fault and rectifying takes very long time, that is high outage time. SF6 gas pressure must be monitored in each compartment. The pressure of gas for operation is very important. Reduction in the pressure of SF6 gas in any module results the flashover and faults. That's why the pressure of SF6 can be maintained continuously. And last one, the SF6 causes ozone depletion and also global warming system. Next one, the difference between AIS and GIS. First, space required in GIS is very small as compared to the AIS. AIS having large. pre-maintenance up to 5 years. Maintenance is required based on the operation in AIS. In GIS, foundation and capitalized cost is high. In AIS, cost is low. In GIS, the polluted area in big cities, it is installed. The AIS, any outside area, it is placed. It required special design of high voltage switchgear, but in AIS there is no any point or design special design is required. Next, in GIS the installation time is much less. In AIS more time should be required. Operation is more reliable in GIS. The operation is less reliable in AIS. The GIS is a more safety, in AIS less safety. The main bus is enclosed in SF6 gas. The main bus is exposed in air in AIS. These are all the points included in this lecture, that is gas insulated substation. Thank you, one and all.